हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल इजी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। आई एम कीर्ति नाशिककर। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द नंबर सिस्टम्स एंड डिजिटल कोर्स। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द नंबर सिस्टम्स वेयर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द डेसिमल नंबर सिस्टम, बाइनरी नंबर सिस्टम, हेक्साडेसिमल एंड ऑक्टल नंबर सिस्टम। Now in this particular lecture we are going to discuss their interconvergence, that is how we are going to convert binary number system or a binary number into a decimal number and a binary number into a hexadecimal number. Okay, and these are the other lectures that we are going to discuss in the future. So this is about the interconvergence of binary to decimal and binary to hexadecimal number system. So let us start with the binary to decimal conversion. Now let us first understand the steps of converting a binary number into its corresponding decimal number. So the very first step is we have to write the given binary number. Then we have to multiply each number with their binary weightage. Now this is very important. We have to multiply each and every binary number with their corresponding binary weightage. Then we have to cancel the weightages which are multiplied by 0, because we know that 0 multiplied by any value resulting into the result 0. And then after cancelling all those values, we have to add the remaining values, and that addition will be the corresponding decimal number of the given binary. So let us understand this with one of the example. I have taken one example which is 1001, and here as 2 is written over here, so that means it is the binary number. And then we have to convert this number into its corresponding decimal, because here at base 10 is given. So 10 means we have to convert this number into its corresponding decimal. Now let us see the steps one by one. First step, write given binary number. We have written it 1001. Then multiply each number with their binary weightage. Now the binary weightage for multiplying this binary weightage, as this is the binary number, so we have to take the binary weightage as 2 into its corresponding power. So here as it is the first place, so we have taken it as the 2 raised to 0. Then for the second place it is 2 raised to 1. Then for the third, the binary weightage will be 2 raised to 2. And for fourth, the binary weightage will be 2 raised to 3. For fifth, 2 raised to 4. For 6th place it is 2 raised to 5, and so on. Okay. Now we have to cancel the weightage which are multiplied by the 0. So here we have already cancelled it, and now we have to add the remaining numbers. So remaining number as 2 raised to 0 into 1 means 1, and 2 raised to 3 is nothing but 8. So it becomes 8 plus 1 equals to 9. So this particular binary number is nothing but the number 9 in the decimal number system. So this is how we can convert the binary number into its corresponding decimal number. Now let us discuss with the binary conversion to decimal, but here the binary numbers are having the decimal point. Now the steps, again we have to write the number, multiply each number with their binary weightage, cancel the weightage which is multiplying with 0, add the remaining numbers. So after seeing these steps, we will understand that both of the steps for conversion of non-decimal and decimal are same. But after seeing the example, we will see the difference between them. So here I have taken one of the number 10101.101 at binary, having 2 at base. So it means this number system is having the radix 2, and only binary number system is having its radix 2. Here radix is 10, means we have to convert it into corresponding decimal number. Again, we have to write given binary number, we have written it. Now we have to multiply each number with their binary weightage. Now we know that before decimal point, means from my side it is left hand side, so towards left hand side we know all these things. We know this, that from this place is 2 raised to 0, this place is 2 raised to 1, third place is 2 raised to, so these are their corresponding binary weightages that we know. But after point these numbers, okay, so here it is 101, so for 1 the corresponding binary weightage after decimal point will be 2 raised to minus 1, so it becomes -1, then for next 2 raised to minus 2, and then for next it is 2 raised to minus 3, and so on. It will continue if the number is more and more increasing. Okay, so before the binary weightage like this, before decimal point, and after decimal point it becomes 2 raised to minus 1, 2 raised to minus 2 minus 3, and so on. Okay, so again the next step, we have to cancel the numbers which are multiplied by 0. So here we have cancelled it, this term, and this term we have cancelled. Okay, now we have to add the remaining numbers. So 2 raised to 4 is nothing but 16, that's why 16. 2 raised to 2 is 4, 2 raised to 0 is 1. Now 1 into 2 raised to minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 2. 1 by 2 becomes 0.5. This term is cancelled, and next 1 into 2 raised to minus 3 is nothing but 1 by 8. 1 by 8 is 0.125. So after this addition we will get the number 21.625 is the corresponding decimal number of 10101.101. So if you understand these procedures, then I have some exercise for you. Here the answers are also given, so you just try to solve this exercise and just verify that your answers are same as the given or not. Now the next conversion is binary to hexadecimal conversion. It is very simple. Here the very first step is that we have to break the binary number into 4 bit sections from the LSB to the MSB. LSB is the least significant bit and MSB is the most significant bit. Convert each 4 bit binary number into its hex equivalent. So let us discuss with one of the example. So here I have taken one of the example, and which is a long string of binary number, and we have to convert it into its corresponding equivalent hex number. So we have to split this string into group of 4 bit binary numbers, so it will become like this. Okay, 4 bit of group of 4 bit is nothing but the nibble, and as we have seen, 1010 first group, 1111 second, 1011 third, and 0010 is the fourth group. Then we have to convert each 4 bit binary number into its hex equivalent. So 0010, its equivalent, hex equivalent is 2. Now this is 1011, so 1010 is A, so 1011 becomes B. 1111 is F for hex, and 1010 is A, so this number becomes AFB2 into its corresponding hexadecimal number system. So this is very simple. You just need to know how to make the grouping of 4 bits. Let us discuss with another example. Here it is the decimal binary number, and we have to convert it into its corresponding hex number. Again, we have to split the given number into its four bit group. So here, first number is 0101, first group, and next one is 1000, and after that, it is the 3-digit. But we have to make the 4-digit equivalent hex. So after decimal point, whatever number is given, we can write any number of zeros to that number. So after 0.001, we can add one more zero and it becomes our group of 4-bit. So now we have to convert this number into its corresponding hex. So it becomes 6, 8, and this number is 2, so it comes after the decimal point. So its corresponding equivalent hex number becomes 68.2. Now these are the exercises. You just have to make the group of 4 bits and you will get the corresponding results. Just verify your result with the given answers. Now the next upcoming lecture will be the decimal to binary and decimal to hexadecimal conversion. In this lecture particularly, we have discussed about the conversion of binary to its corresponding decimal and to its corresponding hexadecimal. And in the upcoming lecture, we are converting the decimal number system into its corresponding binary and its corresponding hexadecimal number system. So thank you so much. If you like my slide, just do share, subscribe and like my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon for further notification. Thank you.